I think we're good.
All right, everybody, welcome back to another video. In this one, we are going to be archery hunting for whitetail deer. Today is actually the opener, and I'm super excited. We got some deer on the game cameras that are mature and ready for an arrow. So I am shooting right now, making sure we're dialed. We just drove up to the ranch. And if you guys are interested or want to know about my setup, I'm shooting a Hoyt Hyperforce. Not the newest bow, I think it's like a 2018, but it does the trick, and I didn't want to spend the money on a brand new bow. This was actually my brother's old bow. He ended up getting a new one, and I decided to get his. Main reason being, it's a lot faster than my other bow, and it's shooting super heavy arrows with like 15 FOC, so these things just zip right through animals. The last bow I was shooting shot really light arrows, a lot slower than this, and it didn't get the penetration that I want. So this bow can take just about anything down, should zip right through whatever I shoot, and I have got it dialed. We're shooting really tight groups out to 60 yards, so I'm excited to hunt with it, and hopefully we have some luck today. But before we head out there, we're gonna get a couple more rounds and make sure we are dialed. Dead deer right there. Bullseye. 30 yards. Let's try 40. We're in there, 40 yards. Oof. Looks gnarly with a broadhead on there.
Guys, so we got four younger whitetail bucks here. One of them is a 10 point, and then the others are eights. Nothing old, mature, and arrow worthy. But Blake is actually hunting not too far from me in another stand, and he said that one of the old cull eights that we want to shoot started walking my direction. He actually had two culls over there. I'm not sure if they just didn't get in range or he decided not to shoot, but there's a decent eight apparently walking our direction. He's old and mature, so if we see him, we're gonna sling an arrow at him. I'll keep you guys posted. Hopefully that eight comes in.
All right, you guys, we are back. Didn't see anything to shoot. Blake did, but it didn't come into comfortable range. But yeah, we're gonna get after it in the morning.
That's how you avoid wounded deer. Be patient, don't take that 40-yard shot. He'll come in to 20 one day.
Yeah, it was at 40 yards, which is an easy shot, but there's just so many factors that could have happened and made it become a not so good shot, you know. Animal could have moved, there was a bunch of other deer, he didn't take it. But that just means that I have another shot at getting that big eight. So yeah, we're gonna get after it in the morning. You guys stay tuned for that. Hopefully we have a little bit more luck than we had tonight. Yeah, we're gonna eat.
right there, right in the pocket, and squeezed it, and I think it shot a little bit high, but my pin was set on 25, and I couldn't, I didn't have time to switch it, so I just had to aim a little bit low, and it still shot a little high, I think, but the way he ran off, and I heard him fall, so we got him. I have one picture of the deer. Y'all, we just got out of the stand. My deer were laying under me, bedding. And yeah, we're at the spot Blake was hunting. It's not too far from where I was at. And he shot a big old cull 7. So, 8 with a kicker. We're back at his spot. And we're gonna track down this deer. Oh, I see him.
Shoot a deer right here
and the deer goes right there.
Dude, he didn't run 30 yards.
I know, that's what I said.
So the pop-up's right in here. Deer came right here, ran 30 yards and dropped.
Look how hidden that is in there.
Yeah, it doesn't even look like the
I know.
Hidden animal. It just looks like you hit the dirt.
Go check him out. Not too far.
Yeah. Dang, good shot.
Cool buck.
Oh, he's got a nice cool kicker.
Yeah.
He's like that other 8 with the split G2s.